Bill, it's an honour to have you here tonight. How does it feel to be celebrating 28 years, a very special anniversary?
Well, it's amazing because when I opened this place, they said it would not last because four restaurants on the site had died. And here we are 28 years later. We've been enjoyed the company over the years of just about every rock and roll artist, every theatre, filming people. Liam Neeson used to come here and read his scripts, and Dylan's been here, and so many people, lots of sports people, and of course Princess Di and the young princes used to come here all the time, so it's rather lovely. Yes, I did propose to Suzanne here about the second or third time, I think. Here she is. Come here.
Hi.
How can you remember that experience? Can you talk us how it felt to be proposed to on this?
It was a bit strange to go from talking about hot dogs to, like, how would you feel if I asked you to marry me?
Enjoy my hot dog.
And then, stop it! Oh my God! And then I said, well, you have to ask me, and then I'll tell you. And he says, well, I'm not going to ask you unless you...
Say yes.
Yeah. So anyhow, that's kind of the way our marriage is, you know, we have discussions about things.
We're 24 years now, so we're catching up with stickies.
Yeah.
One of the most fantastic things, I think, for fans when they get to come to this place is the memorabilia on the walls. I'm curious, is there a particular artifact that means the most to you, that you smile the most when you see it on these walls?
Well, it's my homemade bass guitar, of course, which I made in 2 years before I joined the Stones. I made it because I didn't have a guitar. I didn't have the money, so I made my own homemade bass. And it's hanging on the wall in there, and it's worth more than the restaurant.
Talking of treasure, you've been sharing some of yours with people as well, with the exhibition at the museum. Can you talk to us a little bit about that? Very exciting.
Sharing what?
You're
fine.
You're
fine. And Barry Emmons. Oh, yeah. There's a big exhibition there with a lot of my stuff in there, yeah. Because I've been doing that since 91, doing what I call land fishing. And I found a Roman site that nobody knew was there, and about 300 coins and brooches and all kinds of things. So it's been quite successful, that. So stick is successful, the metal detecting was successful, and then I wrote books about it which were successful, so everything's on the up. Well, I love history as well, you know, and it's very important. I relearned my English history through archaeology, because I did do other archaeological sites as well, and
it's very quiet.
My life's been so varied. You know, I played charity cricket for 12 years and played with all the great cricketers. I just saw that our captain just got his 150 today, which was great. And I've just done so many different things in my life, and this is just a special one. You know, this is a little gem in London, which everybody loves. So I'm just getting over my problems, my health problems.
You're doing a charity benefit, aren't you?
Yes, but I'm doing that in the autumn. I'll just be releasing shortly a new album of the Rhythm Kings, which is really nice. And then I'll be working on my next solo album, I suppose. It's never ending, you know.